Last but very much not least is Dr. Danielle Martin. You know, I think it is high time that we started taking a look at what countries around the world were doing in providing quality care to all of their people in a far more cost-effective way than we do. And one of the examples of a single-payer system that is working well, that is popular, is the Canadian system. Dr. Martin is a Canadian physician, healthcare administrator, and an associate professor at the University of Toronto. She is the author of a Canadian best-selling book, Better Now, 6 Big Ideas to Improve Healthcare for Canadians. Dr. Martin.
Thank you, Senator. I must say I'm very grateful that so many Americans are interested in learning about the experience of your Canadian neighbors under our single-payer healthcare system, which we also call Medicare. As a practicing doctor, a hospital administrator, and a citizen, I am so proud to be part of a system where access to doctor and hospital services is truly based on need, not ability to pay. And I'm not the only one. In public polls, 94% of Canadians say that our healthcare system is a source of personal and collective pride, even more than ice hockey. Single-payer healthcare is a symbol to us of what it truly means to be Canadian, that we take care of each other. Now, my grandparents immigrated to Canada in the early 1950s, like so many people who come to this country, hoping to build a better life for their kids. And at that time, there was no universal health coverage in Canada. So when my grandfather had his first heart attack in his early 40s, his world was shaken. And by the time he died nearly a decade later, the family was essentially bankrupted by medical bills. I know that this remains a reality for many in the United States today, but you should know that just north of your border, that kind of a situation is essentially unimaginable. My generation of Canadians does not remember what it was like to worry about paying a doctor or a hospital bill. And despite our challenges, which of course every country experiences, Canadians have a longer life expectancy, lower infant mortality rates, and fewer preventable deaths than in the United States. Single-payer healthcare is also, as you know, less expensive. In Canada, our administrative overhead is less than 2% in our public plans, as compared to 18% in the private plans here in the US. We spend just under $5,000 per capita in Canada to cover everyone. You spend nearly $10,000 per capita, and yet tens of millions of people are uninsured. But most importantly, when my patients are sick, I do not need to ask if they have insurance or if they can afford to pay for my services. And throughout my pregnancy and for the birth of my daughter in a world-class hospital, I was never asked for money and I never received a bill. I just handed over this card, my Canadian healthcare card, to my doctor, and that was it. I wish that all of my American neighbors could experience the same simplicity in their moments of need. And I hope that the American people will seize this opportunity to declare to each other and to the rest of the world that you do believe access to healthcare is a human right. Thank you. Great job.